In this video, you'll learn about the integration page so that you can get your website, e-commerce store, and third-party apps connected to your MailChimp account. Connecting a site is a great way to have insights about your site or online store right at your fingertips in order to help grow your business. On the integrations page, there are links supported by third-party e-commerce integrations such as WooCommerce, Magento, and ShopSync, website builders such as WordPress and Squarespace, and other useful apps like Eventbrite and Canva. To access the integrations page, we'll click the integrations icon. On the integrations page, we can scroll or use the search bar to find and select the platform we wish to connect to MailChimp. If you have a site already connected, you will see a section with details about that connection. To access the integrations page from here, we'll click Add Another Site to view the full list of supported integrations and connect another site. Keep in mind, the process to connect will vary depending on the option you choose. For more information about MailChimp's supported integrations and how to connect your particular site, check out our guides and tutorials. Once we've connected our site to MailChimp, we can view and manage our integration on the integrations page in our account. We can also switch between sites if we have more than one connected. We'll see the current audience settings for our connected site and can view options to add features depending on the type of site that is connected. If a supported e-commerce store is connected to MailChimp, we can use our synced purchase data to create and send data-driven product retargeting emails or abandoned cart emails to encourage customers to complete their purchase. We can also turn on e-commerce tracking in our campaigns and automations to record our customer purchases and measure ROI. If we want to use Squarespace, WordPress, or custom-coded websites, or a platform that isn't listed on the integrations page, we can add MailChimp's site code to our website's HTML to connect it to MailChimp. This method allows the use of pop-up forms and Google remarketing ads. The best place to add that code varies from site to site. If you're not sure where or how to best modify your site's HTML, MailChimp recommends consulting with your developer or hiring a MailChimp partner to assist you. To disconnect a site, we'll need to remove it in MailChimp, and in most cases, remove the MailChimp integration from the site too. If the site is manually connected, we'll need to remove MailChimp's code from the website's HTML. The process for each site may differ. For more information about disconnecting your site, refer to MailChimp's guides and tutorials. If an e-commerce store is disconnected, MailChimp will automatically pause e-commerce automations. If we want to reconnect our site later, we'll need to follow the complete installation instructions for the e-commerce platform or website and restart any affected customer journeys. That's it. You can now take advantage of these powerful connections offered in MailChimp. For more information about how MailChimp can help you sell more stuff, check out the guides and tutorials.